Hey folks, my name is Burke, and in this video, we're going to take a look at how to set up a custom domain with Azure Static Web Apps. It's pretty straightforward, but there's a few things that you got to know. So let's check it out. In this video, we'll set up a custom domain for an Azure Static Web App. First, we'll configure the www subdomain. Then we'll configure the root domain. A root domain is just the domain without any www or any other subdomain. First, navigate to your static web app in the Azure portal. Select the custom domains item in the sidebar. Next, click the add button. Input the domain into the domain name field with the desired subdomain. In this case, www. And click next. The next step is to validate this subdomain by creating a CNAME record with my domain provider that points to this static web app. To do that, copy this value using the clipboard icon. Now log into your domain provider and find the domain configuration settings. Add a new CNAME record. Enter www for the host field and paste in the URL you copied from the Azure portal for the value field. Back in the Azure portal, click the Add button. Azure will now add the subdomain to your static web app. This can take a while depending on how long it takes for the DNS changes that you just made to propagate from your provider. Then Azure will take care of setting up an SSL certificate for you, which takes some additional time. You can refresh this main page to see the current status of your subdomain. Azure reports that the subdomain is now ready. And you can test it by navigating to www.yourdomain.com. Now we'll configure the root domain. Click on the Add button on the custom domain screen. Enter the domain without the www portion. The next step is to validate that I own this domain by creating a TXT record with the domain provider with a code given to me by Azure. Click on Generate Code to get that code that you'll need for validation. This can take several minutes. When the code has been generated, click the copy icon to copy the value to your clipboard. You'll see that it says validating out here to the side. This means that Azure is waiting for you to create the TXT record with your domain provider so that it can validate that you own this domain. So let's do that. Log into the domain provider and find the DNS configuration screen. On the DNS configuration screen, add a new TXT record type. Set the name to the @ and paste in the generated code value from your clipboard for the value field. Make sure you save the record so that it is created. Now Azure will validate this TXT record. You don't have to do anything to start that process because it's already running. You can check on the progress by returning to your static site in the Azure portal and looking under custom domains. This can take a while. You can close the configuration flyout if you like and just refresh the main section to see progress. Once the TXT record validation is complete, a green checkmark will appear next to it with the text ready. Now you can complete the root domain setup by adding an alias record. First, you'll need the auto-generated URL for your static web app. You can copy the URL value right here in the Azure portal where it says auto-generated as the type. Back in your DNS provider's configuration screen, add an alias record. If your domain provider does not have an alias as an option, try using a CNAME instead. Some domain providers support the same functionality that you'll get with an alias record through something called CNAME flattening. For the name, enter the @. For the value, paste in the URL that is on your clipboard. And click Save to save the alias record. If you get an error when you try and save, make sure that you didn't accidentally include HTTP or HTTPS on the front of the URL, as alias and CNAME records don't allow the protocol to be included. And that's it. Your root domain is now configured. Test it out by typing the root domain in your browser and it should return your static web app. If it doesn't, it may be because domain changes haven't fully propagated yet. Depending on where you are, this can take some time. So wait and check back a little later.